What is up, Wildlings? Colin here, the CEO of Wild Foods. We got an article today that I want to talk about that needs more attention. It's the idea of children eating sugar and the idea that some people believe that children actually need sugar. So the question is, do children need sugar or perhaps do they need flavor? They want sugar because it lights up the pleasure centers in their brain. That's an evolutionary response to something that in the wild used to be scarce. So therefore, we wanted it and we were rewarded for finding it because it helped us put fat on our body, basically. Sugar converts to fat very easily in the body. And that's why we were incentivized to eat a lot of it if we came across it. In our modern world, though, it's everywhere. And it usually comes in the form of heavily processed, chemically treated, mass-produced, machine-made, shipped around the world ingredients that are made in a facility by robots that we recognize as food because there's a nutrition panel on it. I have a young son and he's always craving the energy, which is fat and carbs. And so we're always trying to prioritize protein, which is the nitrogen. And this gets into the PE ratio or the PE diet that was coined by Ted Nyman, Dr. Nyman. I highly recommend looking into that. It's an easy way to think about nutrition. We should always be prioritizing protein because that's where the nitrogen is. That's the most metabolically expensive to consume and the most satiating nutrient there is, which is protein, right? Ideally from healthy animal sources. Then what's left over is energy. You have fat and you have sugar, both of which are primarily energy sources that if we eat too much in abundance, easily convert to excess fat on the body. Now, kids run around, they burn a lot of calories, they have what some people call fast metabolisms. But does that mean that they should be eating a lot of energy, particularly a lot of sugar, right? Well, they burn it off, no big deal. But there is obviously a lot of nuance to that. Like I mentioned how the form of the sugar is generally coming from packaged foods that may have other things like grains and seed oils and other toxic ingredients, literally toxic. And the more you eat them, the more toxic they become. So no, I don't believe children should eat anything out of a package for the most part or anything that's made by a big company. It is what it is. But if you're making things at home, like we make watermelon and strawberry popsicles for our son, and then we freeze them. So it's basically fruit. And I think we use a little bit of xylitol. I don't even know if we add any sweetener. Maybe you do like apple juice or something just to sweeten a little bit. And then we freeze that in this little popsicle tray. And then we give that to him and he loves it. We have things like cashew butter and almond butter, and he always craves those. And his diet is almost always food that we make at home. We try to avoid giving him any restaurant food, anything out of a package, etc. There are obviously a few brands of things that we do buy. We have the Serenity Kids pouches that we have when mom's on the go and she needs something to appease him and everything. We also make like trail mix type stuff and we put that in a silicone pouch and she takes that as well. Always have a thing of water. That's very important. Prioritizing protein and constantly fighting against their desire for energy, particularly sugar, is going to be a never-ending battle. You can set yourself up for success to mitigate that as much as possible by having healthy options. So that's kind of its own thing, and that requires some unpacking and some strategy around for sure. But this core idea that I want to bring to you, this core message, if you're a parent, is you should not feel good about giving your children sugar. That just kind of is what it is. Some people may not want to hear that. It's not easy to hear, but the truth is very rarely easy to hear. Children should not be eating sugar all the time. They should also not be eating processed seed oils and grains and things like that that are made by big corporations in a package and they're just straight up not good for you. Like, again, it's a topic for another day, but you could kind of lump them all together. Stop feeding kids processed refined foods full of grains and sugar and seed oils. And that right there will be the most impactful thing that you can do for the long-term health of your children. Period, hands down, bar none. The point about flavor here is to give them something in lieu of sugar. And if you're going to try to break the sugar habit, if they're already eating sugar on a regular basis, they're already craving it and asking for it, you're going to have to provide them flavor. Make things at home. Find easy on-the-go recipes. You can make things like xylitol gummies using some tea and some gelatin or things like that. There's so many cool kid-friendly recipes that you can find that if you have them and you give them to kids, even if they're asking for something like sugar or whatever, over time, if that's all they're presented with, their palate will change. They will stop craving the very palatable, highly refined, highly sugar ingredients and foods that you were giving them before, and they'll move to wanting it less, and then they'll move to even asking for it less. And then you can move them more to protein, eating clean, whole foods, eating, you know, if they want sugar, it's going to have to come in the form of fruit. They're going to have to eat fruit. And then you build the rest of their eating around home-cooked real food, things that are prepped at home, not out of a package, and not made in some factory far away. It's a short idea geared towards parents, but this advice also applies to adults, actually. The reality is that adults in our environment that is loaded with seed oils and grains and sugar and just very high energy foods with low protein, low nitrogen. We crave these foods. And when we go to restaurants, we eat out of a package or we eat those convenience foods, we crave them even more. It's an addiction. It really is. So for you, parent and the child, prioritize protein. Deprioritize highly refined forms of energy, particularly sugar and grains. Aim for eating a lot of healthy fat, a lot of healthy, clean protein. And then fill in the gaps here and there with starch-less carbs, you know, veggies, fruit here and there, etc. That, at the end of the day, is going to be the best eating plan for every human, regardless of you're just getting out, started in life, or you're reaching your tail end years, or you're right in between in the middle. Prioritize protein, healthy, clean fats, and then lastly, carbohydrates, starch, sugar, etc. Ideally, not in the form of something that's made in a package in a factory. That's going to be it for today's short show. I'm Colin. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Colin Stuckert. Get on the Wild newsletter over at wildfoods.co, and I'll see you in the next one.